This is the session I played directly after my previous video at the Aria. This is also a 1-2 with a $5 buy-in, except the buy-ins are much deeper. And you're going to see double board bomb pots every dealer change. So I hope you're excited. It's a fun one. We're in for 500. Let's get into it. So this session, we start out at the must move table. We're playing four-handed. I look down at king 7-3-3, triple suited to the king in the small blind. Folds to me. I already have a $5 chip out there. So I call and the big blind checks. So we're going heads up to a flop. Flop comes king, queen, three with two diamonds. I check and the big blind checks back. So still heads up here to a turn. Turn brings another queen. I continue slow playing and check. My opponent takes the bait and bets 10. I check raise to 40 and he folds. So we take it down. So I play a little while longer here at the must move table. Didn't really get a ton to play until we get moved into the main game. After a little while here at the main game, we do get our first dealer change and our first $20 double board bomb pot. So for those of you who are not familiar with it, everyone puts in $20. And you're gonna get your typical four cards and it's gonna go straight to the flop with two boards. So basically the winner of each board is gonna get half the pot. So I have ace, ace, 4-3 rainbow here in the hijack and the boards are dealt jack, 8-8 with two clubs and ace, 10-3 with two spades. Early position player pots it for 180, folds to me. And I think a little bit here, I'm not too familiar with double board bomb pot strategy, but I feel like top set here, and you know, obviously aces and eights on the other board, I just have to go with it. So I push and folds back to the original bettor and she calls as well. So we're going heads up to two runouts. Turn brings a deuce of clubs on the top board, nine of spades on the bottom board. River brings an eight of spades on the top board and a queen of spades on the bottom board. And she turns over her hand, she has jack, jack, 7-6. So she flopped the full house on the bottom and just has a pair of jacks on the top. So it looks like we're gonna chop it up here. Didn't really get many hands worth playing after that bomb pot until we looked down at ace 996, single suited to the ace in the small blind in another bomb pot. So we're going to two flops. Flops come ace queen three with two diamonds on the top and 7-6-4 with two clubs on the bottom. I check, next player bets 180. There's three callers back to me. And I was thinking I kind of had to go with the hand before I checked, but then obviously now with a bet and three calls, I for sure have to just go with it. So I push, next player to act, he has everyone covered, he calls. Then the next guy is tanking for a little bit, he ends up pushing over the top a little bit more, and the two late position players call, they have less, and back to the big stack to my left, he calls. So we're going five ways to a run out. Turn brings a queen of hearts on the top, ace of hearts on the bottom. River brings two of spades on the top and ace of spades on the bottom. All right, so first player to show is the big stack to my left. He shows king 8-5-2. So he flopped the straight on the bottom and he has a pair of twos on the top. Then the next person to show, she has king jack 8-4. So she had a royal flush draw on the top and she had a pair and a straight draw on the bottom. And then the last player shows jack 7-4-2. So she flopped two pair and has a pair of twos. So we turn over our hand and somehow we're gonna scoop. We had the enough flush draw. We could have won with a club on that board, but we went the hard way with the running aces and our aces and queens is good on the top. So taking down a nice pot here in the early going. So here I look down at ace 6-5-4, single suited to the ace in the small blind. There's a middle position open to 15, late position caller, I call, and we're going three ways to a flop. Flop comes 9-6-3 with two spades, I check, and both the late position players check, so still three ways to a turn. Turn brings another three, I decide to lead 35, and both players fold, so we take it down. So here's another double board bomb pot I play, queen 7-6-2, double suited on the button. Flops came jack, jack 10 with two clubs, and ace 3-2 with two diamonds. Player in the big blind ended up potting it. Next player pushed, ended up getting back to the same player who ended up calling, and they ended up going heads up. It was jack 10 versus ace king of diamonds, and they ended up chopping. And I was explaining it to one of the guys at the table, I feel like bomb pots are very similar to high-low, if you ever played that, where a lot of the times, one side of the hand, either the high or the low, is pretty much locked up, and then it's just, there's maybe a small percentage chance the other player can somehow scoop. Let me know what you guys think about that. Here I look down at ace, ace, queen, queen, single suited to the ace under the gun. I open to 15. There's three callers back to the big blind who makes it 25. I call and the other players call. So we're going five ways to a flop. Flop comes king, king, eight with two diamonds. Checks to me, I check. Late position player bets 60. Folds to me and I fold as well. Here I look down at ace, queen, 10, 9, double suited under the gun. I make it 15, and we get one caller, so we're going heads up to a flop. Flop comes jack, 10, 6 with two spades. I check, and my opponent checks back, so still heads up to a turn. Turn brings an 8, I check, and my opponent doesn't take the bait and checks back, so still heads up to a river. River brings another 10, I can't slow play anymore, I bet $10, and my opponent calls. I turn over my hand, and we're good. So as I'm taking in that pot, I hear a roar behind me and I look over and there's just a massive amount of people around this table. And I can see through the crowd that there's this person, he's kissing babies and signing autographs. And I look over and it's the Brad Owen of Hold'em. And since I've been known as the Brad Owen of PLO by at least one viewer 3 months ago, let's give a little love to the Brad Owen of Hold'em by liking and subscribing his videos. You know, he can really, really use the support. He's really hurting for subscribers. So link in my bio. So I mentioned earlier that I believe bomb pots are very similar to high-low. And if you've ever played high-low, there's a term that's called quartered. It's where typically where there's three players in a hand and you're going to put your money in, but you end up getting quartered, only a quarter of your money back, because you and another player have the same hand. Whether, you know, a lot of times it'll be like an ace deuce in high-low, and the other player will have the high. So that's kind of what happens here. So there's a double board bomb pot, ace, king, king, 7-5, and then jack, 10, 9, 8, 2. And two players have ace, king, and the other guy has 9-7 for the straight. So kind of what happens sometimes here in bomb pots. Here, look down at ace, ace, 4-4, single suited to the ace in the big blind. Under the gun opens 15, there's five callers, and I call. So we're going seven ways to a flop. Flop comes queen, 7-5, rainbow. I check, original raiser bets 25. There's two callers and I call, so we're going four ways to a turn. Turn brings a king of diamonds, bringing in the backdoor flush draw, and action checks through, so we're still going four ways to a river. River brings a three of diamonds, small blind checks, I check, and action checks through again. Small blind shows his hand, he has 7-6-5-4 double suited with the flush, and he's gonna take it down. Here, look down at ace, king, 10-7, single suited to the ace on the button. There's an early position limp, middle position makes it 20. One caller, I call, and the limper calls. So we're going four ways to a flop. Flop comes jack, 9-5, all hearts. So pretty good flop for me, obviously. And the original raiser bets 50. And here, my old self would have definitely just called. And I decide to fast play it and raise to 200. And back to the original raiser, he thinks for a little bit and folds. So maybe I could have made it a little smaller. I don't believe flatting there is the right play, but let me know what you guys think about that one. Here, look down at king, king, queen, six, double suited under the gun. I make it 15 and we get five callers, so we're going six ways to a flop. Flop comes king, jack, 7 with two hearts. Small blind leads 45, folds to me. Pretty easy decision here, I make it 200 and folds back to the small blind. He pushes for about 310 total and of course I call, so we're going heads up to a run out. Turn brings an ace of hearts, probably the worst card in the deck. River brings a meaningless 4 and my opponent turns over his hand. He has jack, jack, 5-4. With the jack 4 of hearts. So had him in pretty bad shape on the flop, but he gets there and takes it down. I was thinking about leaving before that hand, and then once that hand hit, I just felt like it was a sign to take my profits, so that's what I do. What's up guys, just finished up here. I was in for 500, out for 1873, so a profit of 1373. It was my first ever double bore bomb pot experience, and obviously that was the main hand there with the ace 996. I wasn't sure how to play it, but then once I saw, you know, four people call a pretty big bet in front of me, I just had to go with it. And obviously got pretty lucky there to hit running aces on the one board and somehow winning with a pair of aces on the other. So that was obviously the main hand. Won some small pots, nothing really of crazy note. And then obviously at the end there, raised with the double suited kings under the gun. You know, made it 200 on the king jack 7 or king jack flop. He told me he would have folded if he didn't have the flush draw. And then obviously the turn brought in the flush right away. So nothing you could do about that, but pretty good game. I mean, the game was good most of the day, and then a lot of the action players ended up leaving the main table I was at and going to the other table. So it kind of got a little worse, but still pretty good. Definitely happy with my play. Let me know what you guys think. If you guys enjoyed it, please hit the like and subscribe button. If your viewing experience could have been better, please let me know how down in the comments below, and I'll see you guys next time. Take care.